Welcome back to Cheddar News. Our next segment, The Future of Work, is brought to you by ADP, exploring the digital transformations that are transforming the workplace as we know it. And technology has greatly changed the way human resources departments operate over recent years, and the pandemic, well, has accelerated these changes, paving the way for the future of HR. So joining us now to discuss more is Bob Lockett, Chief Diversity and Talent Officer at ADP. Bob, can you break down how the pandemic has changed traditional hiring and, of course, the recruiting process?
Yes, Alicia, I would tell you that pre-pandemic, the recruiting process was done in person, and many companies leveraged this opportunity to talk to their potential prospects in live and in person. Now, the pandemic affected this in many ways in businesses of all sizes, basically where they recruit and how they do it. Now, for employers, the main challenge has really been finding the talent that's right for them that will meet the needs of their organization with an eye on the future as well. Now, add to that, some workers have also opted not to rejoin the workforce. And the result, a tight labor market, which you'll see some reports of labor shortages in some industries. Now, in response to that, most employers have really taken a stance to say, we've got to look for talent in traditional and non-traditional ways. And so the reality is, even before the pandemic, many employers were missing out on potential talent because we didn't tap into diverse markets. And now that's more important than ever in terms of your overall recruiting strategy. And of course, as many businesses have seen the success of remote work, they're more willing to look at different geographies for specific roles. And I always say that if you broaden the pond in which you fish, you're likely to catch a variety of different fish. And this really helps us think about virtual recruiting events and interviews that are virtual, and that helps us find talent in so many different pockets of the world and of our country too.
You kind of touched on my next question there in terms of, what role has technology played in transforming human resources overall?
So, technology in general has just revolutionized the way in which we think about HR. It allows leaders and HR folks to be much more strategic about the types of roles needed, the workforce demographics, engagement, employee sentiment, around issues of performance and data. And of course, organizations can do these things in minutes now as opposed to hours, thanks to this new technology. And essentially, newer technology is making data more actionable for HR and business leaders. Now, with these technological insights, business leaders and HR folks are able to sort of make better decisions that improve overall performance and mitigate risk. Now, in some cases, you take a look at the applicant tracking system that exists now. It allows leaders to understand how many people applied for a role, where they came from, and where they are in the hiring process. This helps leaders and recruiters understand the success of their recruiting efforts and the pain points. Now, these tools also can help, with both internal and external recruiting efforts. Internally, companies also use HR technology for succession planning and for internal movement of talent. And using these tools can help us save time and money and help employees make better career choices in advance so they can continue to add value in their companies. And of course, thanks to emerging technology like bots and AI, we continue to see the function of HR become increasingly more strategic, and it's threaded throughout all of the business activities in a more meaningful way.
It's no secret that we saw just unprecedented growth of remote working during the past year and a half, obviously with the impact of the pandemic. And we're still seeing the hybrid model accelerate in a way that we wouldn't have maybe 2 years or so ago. So I wonder if you could break down, what people can expect from virtual interviews versus the traditional kind of in-person ones that many are used to, and how employers can really ensure that they are being effective either way they do these.
And of course, Alicia, there are different advantages for both formats. For certain industries, there are roles that may be better equipped for in-person interviews versus other businesses. Virtual interviews open up the talent pools, but we already touched on a little bit, where geography isn't an issue and it allows employers to reach a diverse array of talent. Now, both formats, for employers and candidates, you have to prepare in very similar ways. With virtual interviews, you have to pay particular attention to things like your technology setup and your background, because distractions are very easy to come by when we don't care for those two items. But both formats require employees and candidates to show up with their best selves, be prepared, pay attention to things like body language and messaging. And for in-person interviews, there are nuances associated with that as well, which you know, you have to think about it. You get some insights from those things, but the key here is to listen and capture responses both verbally and non-verbally. It's critical to build rapport either way you think about it. And when interviewing or conducting an interview in person or whether it's virtual, it's important to limit your distractions and listen intently with the intention to understand. Hiring managers really have to be sensitive to the fact that the format may work well for some and be a challenge for others. Well, how do you compensate for that? It requires employers to have an awareness of the candidate's strengths with the context of the role in which they might play within their organization. Now, if you're an employer, whether you're hiring or onboarding someone, you have to figure out what the appropriate method of communication is for the person in the role, whether it's video, a phone call, in person, and you've got to balance those needs to create meaningful connections. And the key here is to ensure there is engagement and the person feels like they already belong as part of your organization.
Yeah. Here's a big one here that I hope is helpful to our viewers. You know, what are the biggest skills that recruiters are looking for right now?
Certainly those skills vary industry by industry and certainly by the size of the business that you're looking for. But generally speaking, the most critical skills are rooted in understanding technology and the ability to solve problems. Top candidates also demonstrate flexibility. They have great collaboration skills because I still believe companies hire people they like, not necessarily those that are always the best qualified. You have to have grit and a growth mindset to help businesses improve their performance and solve their problems. Now, over the last year, we've seen changes emerging very fast, and having the right skills and the right attitude to be flexible in the workplace helps you sort of stand out. Now, given all the things that have happened around us over the last year or so, like social unrest, the pandemic, financial crisis, and natural disasters, employees need grit and ability to adapt to the situation, learn new skills, apply technology, and certainly have empathy for those around them in order to move forward and to thrive no matter what the future holds.
All right, helpful tips there from Bob Lockett, Chief Diversity and Talent Officer at ADP. Thank you so much, Bob. All right, to learn more about the top trends that are reshaping the future of work, visit adp.com/y-adp.